Now we will solve questions from practice set 9.2. Question number 1. Perpendicular height of cone is 12 cm and its slant height is 13 cm. Find the radius of the base of the cone. Perpendicular height of cone is 12 cm and its slant height is 13 cm. Find the radius of the base of the cone. Solution. We know L square equal to R square plus H square. L square equal to R square plus H square. L is slant height, R is radius of the base and H is perpendicular height of the cone. So L square equal to R square plus H square. But slant height is given 13. So here L square means 13 square equal to R square. You have to find out radius. So R square plus and perpendicular height is given 12. So H square means 12 square. So 13 square equal to R square plus 12 square. 13 square is 169 equal to R square plus 12 square is 144. So 169 equal to R square plus 144. Now 169 minus 144 equal to R square. Therefore R square equal to 25. R square equal to 25. Therefore R equal to 5. Square root of 25 is 5. Therefore R equal to 5. Therefore, radius of the cone is 5 cm. Radius of the cone is 5 cm. Now, question number 2. Find the volume of a cone if its total surface area is 7128 square cm and radius of base is 28 cm. Find the volume of a cone if its total surface area is 7128 square centimeter and radius of base is 28 centimeter and the value of pi is given 22/7. So first use formula of total surface area of a cone and find out L. So total surface area of a cone equal to pi r into r plus L. But total surface area of a cone is given 7128. So substitute here. 7128 equal to and the value of pi is given 22/7. So 22/7 into and radius of the base is given 28. So into 28 into then in bracket r plus l means 28 plus l. Now simple transposition 7128 into 7 upon 22 into 28. Equal to 28 plus L. 7128 into 7 upon 22 into 28 equal to 28 plus L. Therefore 324 upon 4 equal to 28 plus L. Therefore 81 equal to 28 plus L. Therefore L equal to 81 minus 28. Therefore L equal to 53 centimeter. So slant height of a cone is 53 centimeter. Now find out volume of a cone. But first find out h, height of a cone. So L square equal to R square plus H square. We know L square equal to R square plus H square. But L slant height is 53. Slant height is 53. So L square means 53 square equal to radius of base is given 28. So R square means 28 square plus H square. Find out height. So 53 square minus 28 square equal to h square. 53 square minus 28 square equal to h square. Therefore h square equal to use here identity a square minus b square, that is a plus b into a minus b. So 53 square minus 28 square equal to 53 plus 28 into 53 minus 28. So h square equal to 53 plus 28 into 53 minus 28. Therefore h square equal to 53 plus 28 is 81 into 53 minus 28 is 25. So h square equal to 81 into 25. Now taking square root. So h equal to square root of 81 is 9 into square root of 25 is 5. So h equal to 9 into 5. Therefore h equal to 45 centimeter. Therefore perpendicular height of a cone is 45 centimeter. Now find out volume of a cone. So volume of a cone equal to 1 upon 3 pi r square h. Volume of a cone equal to 1 upon 3 pi r square h. Equal to 1 upon 3 into and the value of pi is given 22/7. So substitute here 22/7 into radius is 28. So 28 r square means 28 into 28 into height is 45. Height is 45. So substitute here 45. Therefore, volume of a cone equal to 36,960 cubic centimeter or centimeter cube. Volume of a cone equal to 36,960 cubic centimeter or centimeter cube. So volume of the cone equal to 36,960 cubic centimeter. Now question number 3. Core surface area of a cone is 251.2 centimeter square and radius of its base is 8 centimeter. Find its slant height and perpendicular height. The value of pi is given 3.14. Core surface area of a cone is 251.2 centimeter square and radius of its base is 8 centimeters. So find its slant height and perpendicular height means you have to find out L and H. So first use formula of curved surface area of a cone. So curved surface area of a cone equal to pi r l. Curved surface area of a cone equal to pi r l. But curved surface area of a cone is given 251.2. So substitute here 251.2 equal to the value of pi is given 3.14. The value of pi is given 3.14. So 3.14 into and radius is given 8. Radius is given 8. So 8 into L. So 251.2 we can write as 2512 upon 10 equal to 3.14 we can write as 314 upon 100 into 8 into L. Now simple transposition 2512 into 100 upon 10 into 314 into 8. So 2512 into 100 upon 10 into 314 into 8 equal to L. Therefore 314 into 10 upon 314 equal to L. Therefore L equal to 10 centimeter. So slant height of a cone is 10 centimeter. Now find out perpendicular height, that is H. So we know L square equal to R square plus H square. But L is 10. So L square means 10 square equal to R is given 8. So R square means 8 square plus H square. So 10 square is 100. 8 square is 64. So 100 minus 64 equal to H square. Therefore H square equal to 36. Therefore H equal to 6. Square root of 36 is 6. So therefore H equal to 6 centimeter. Therefore, but what is H? Perpendicular height. Therefore, slant height of the cone is 10 centimeter. Slant height of the cone. L is slant height of the cone. Therefore, slant height of the cone is 10 centimeter. And H is perpendicular height of the cone. So, perpendicular height of the cone is 6 centimeter.